Let's continue your tutorial. So before we forget, we should have at least a property line, right? We have to let's define our property line on where we will be working on for our site development. So when you're working on a property line, you have to be on the site floor plan. So under floor plans here, double click on site, it will bring you to the site. So the site view range, alam niyo na yung view range, right? View range looks from the roof, okay? It looks above the roof. So you can see the roof at this time, which is what we are showing as architects, right? We're showing the roof, and of course, we'll have to show the property line. We show the site development, like if you have walkways, if you have a driveway, if you have a fence, if you have, of course, your landscape, it can be shown here. Before we add all of those site enhancement, let's identify or let's draw our property line. So in your massing and site tab, this is where we do the property line. You have here property line. Okay, let's click on property line. You have two options. First is create by sketching, and the other one is create by entering distances and bearings. We will not do the create by entering distances and bearing, but I will show to you how this works. If I click that, this will pop out. It will ask you for a distance, for bearing, direction, and all of those, even radius. So ito, if you have your property data information showing the distances and bearings of your plot, then you can just enter it here. Then automatically it will be plotted in your project. Of course, when you have this data, before you start the project, you have to do the property line first. Not like what we did now, because we were just doing the building first. For the sake of teaching you on the step-by-step way of creating a structure. So for now, we will go to the other way of doing a property line, which is doing it by sketch. So cancel muna natin ito. Let's go back to property line, and you do create by sketching. So we're just in draw mode right here now. It is showing us the line. Let's draw it freely. You draw it from there. Say that's your property. And something like this. Maybe that's our property. Let's have it parallel to this wall. So there will be a reason why we sort of slanted that wall. Okay, so it is showing that it is parallel to the wall that we have drawn earlier. So click lang natin yan, and then we just close it right here. Of course, let's always close that line, trim. If we feel that it's too long, we can pull it a little bit shorter. Let's say standard lang natin siya sa hinihingi na setback, which is 2 meters. Click enter there. And in front, if you want to pull it, let's say make it just 5 meters right there, I'll be fine. Okay, so yun ang property line natin. So when we're done, you just have to click the check, at lalabas na yan according to your scale, showing it as that type of line, the line type that we use for the properties. So that's your property line. What else can you do in the massing and site? You can do the topo surface. The topo surface will be your topography. If you have the topography information, you can plot it, you can trace it in your project. That's a little bit complicated. We'll not go there yet. We'll just do a temporary topography. Okay, so click on topo surface. We'll create a topo surface around your property line let's say, here it says place a point. So we'll place a point on several parts of your drawing area, which is covering your property line. Okay, that's fine. If you can see, the point that we have placed is at elevation 0. Elevation 0. So what if we want to change those points and make them lower than our property? We can do that, of course. But let's add a few more points at 0. Let's say the one nearest to the property is already 0. Then the ones outside of your, at the edge of the property, we can just click Control to add them into the selection. Let's have them at -500. And then let's add a few more points. Let's say here. These points will make them high. Let's make them, let's say, 1, 200. That as well is 1, 200. Also this, make it 1, 200. I'm not doing anything to the drawing. Okay, I'm just entering data. Revit is automatically sort of creating your topography map. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, let's put another point. That's okay. Place another point here. We're gonna have to, that point there is 1, 8. Okay, so that's like a high point there. When you're done, just click check. And let's look at our 3D view. And put it at your shaded mode. You'll see that somehow you have like a hill somewhere there. Okay. So if you have your topography with you, pwede natin yan i-trace, and then you can have the topography showing in your model. Right? Let's go back to our site plan. So, question, why is the property line not showing in the 3D view? Yeah, because the property line is usually an imaginary line in your property. It is not a 3D entity. Okay, so what we are showing in the 3D view are 3D entities. So, what can we do to show the property line? Of course, we can do the boundary wall. Lagyan natin ng bakod. Let's go to your site plan. And let's create a boundary wall. Go to your architecture. Go to wall. Wall architecture. Let's just have 140 mm masonry. We'll have the base constraint at ground level. Ground level actually is 300, right? And do we have another? Let's have the base offset at -300, so it goes to 0. And then we'll have this as unconnected. Let's give it a value. Let's make it 1800. Click apply. Now let's start drawing. Now what you can do is you can just select the property wall. Select this, pick lines, and then the location line will be the finish space exterior. Let's see what happens. Yeah, you can select that and you can just flip it. Select the wall, flip it. Select that wall, flip it. And select that, flip. Select. You have your boundary wall. So go to your 3D view, and that's your boundary wall. So we can further enhance that later on. We can put on the opening, we can put the gate, we can put on other things. And of course, one of the easiest thing that you can do in Revit is adding landscape. Go back to your site plan. Let's check our families here if we already have planting. Luckily, we already have the planting. We have the RPC trees, so you can choose all of these things. What you can do is you can just select from all of these. Say Lombardy poplar, that's a big tree. You can just drag and drop it. Drag and drop lang tayo. And maybe this scarlet oak. And maybe this Flexinus. Once you put them in place, after putting them in place, you change your mind, select one, you can change it to another type. Selected one, you can change it to another type. Maybe a bigger one. You can select this and then change it, no problem. Oh, no. Select it and then change it here. Change it right there. Put it in one. This can be changed there. Okay? Say select multiple, then you can change them here. Make them Japanese chair, whatever. So look at your 3D view. You already placed some of your trees. Okay, so that's your lesson. A little bit of massing insight. And I'll see you on your next tutorial. Thank you very much.